Guys of Reddit, what turns you off? Total passivity. Never taking the initiative or trying anything. Visible efforts to show me that they're not going to make an effort for me. Disinterest in my emotional state. Listen, I may not get emotional often, but when I have a moment, don't blow it off like you're a dude, get over it. Lack of compassion, being self-centered. Lack of empathy. Mainly, when it's clear she doesn't give much of a shit. Want to be wanted, I want to feel like she wants me as much as I want her. If I feel I gotta twist her arm, I'm pretty much done. My arm needs zero twisting when I'm interested. Not putting in the same effort as you. I honestly can't remember the last time someone has made an equal effort to see me as I have them. It's especially disheartening in this age. I just remember what it was like when everyone didn't have phones, where phone culture wasn't set even if they did, when people are on their phones constantly and you realize that waiting for a day or two or four for a reply to a basic message makes your priority to this person very, very low. When I'm trying to spend time with her, whether we're out or just spending some time together relaxing, and she spends the whole time looking at her phone. If we're on a date and she pulls out her phone at the table to start scrolling, I'm done. Aversion to weirdness or uniqueness. If someone thinks it's weird to be super interested in something, I find that very off-putting. People who are intentionally rude and mean for no reason. I hate them with all my soul. Being mean to others for no reason. How does this person treat waitstaff? The real first impression. Projection and thinking that you can read my thoughts. Ask questions, I'm happy to answer, but don't assume you know what I'm thinking or why I did something, especially if it's based on your experience with a previous partner. When they try to get an emotional rise out of you just to see if you care. Being bitchy to people who aren't in a position to defend themselves, like people in the service industry. People who are kind no matter the circumstances are emotionally intelligent and sexy AF. Powerful people don't need to be petty. Playing dumb. Liars. Bullies. Cheaters. Emotional volatility. You can have emotions and not take them out on others, or exhibit some control, all at the same time. It's everyone's responsibility to not take them out on others. Not leaving me alone and getting upset if I don't reply within 90 seconds. Being rude/mean to others for no reason. Bad hygiene is an automatic turn-off. No way back from it. When a girl is upset and I'm expected to know/guess what made her mad, be straightforward and tell me so I can either apologize or explain myself. A woman addicted to social media. When I am talking about something I'm passionate about and she was looking at her phone and in another world completely, just saying uh-huh and yes at the right time so I don't notice. Playing a healer in a MMO and becoming more popular than me, taking over my guild, then kicking me for low DPS. Bitch. Stupidity and ignorance. Smart chicks are hot. When a woman is smarter than me, I'll adore that shit. Let me be a himbo and ask dumb questions, please. I can only be smart for so long, office hours. I need my bimbo time. Playing dumb. Poor hygiene. Being judgy. Just let people be who they are. It's all good if we aren't the same. Not saying thank you. I just cooked a whole ass dinner and you're not gonna say thanks. Double standards. Lack of curiosity. I would say that curiosity is the mathematical derivative of intelligence. The water drop that broke the camel's back with my ex-fiancé was when she refused to have a conversation about God and religion because, I quote, I'm afraid you might make me change my mind. My new antidepressants. Doesn't care about animals, treats them badly or sees them as just some object. Having no interests, which then makes me your number one interest. Picking out a ring, saying yes, and then deciding to cheat. Also, drawn on eyebrows. Smell. Ignorance. A complete lack of introspection is an instant deal breaker for me. Like, really? You're just gonna not question why anything happens? Or even why you are who you are? Lack of openness or being fake. If I am going to be in a situation where I am going to be turned on to start with, I want some freaking intimacy, damn it. Being too serious, and only being a joker. I need someone in between. Women that act like teenagers. I've met 18-year-olds, obviously, that act like kids, and I've met 25-year-olds that act like kids, and no matter how hot they are, I'm immediately turned off by it. I don't even really know how to describe it, but their immaturity and glaring lack of real-world life experiences make them seem annoying and petty. Somebody who just, no matter what, cannot get off their phone. Whining. I used to be a winner, then I kind of got over it and pulled myself up by my emotional bootstraps, and now listening to endless whining is such a turnoff for me. However, there's a difference between whining and bitching, in my view. Whining is complaining about a problem while doing nothing to solve it. Bitching is venting about a problem while you're working on it. I have no problem with bitching. I'm probably too late, but I didn't see either of these two said, one being fake, LM not into pretending or putting on a show for everyone else. Too confrontational / aggressive, yelling, getting in people's faces, threatening to beat someone, or anything like that is a hard pass for me. Just walk away and be mature. I don't need you to prove how tough you are. When the girl tries and shove things up my ass midway, don't ask. This will ultimately get buried. I spent 11 years trying to prove to someone that I care/loved them. We split up in 2012, and had 2 children, spent many years coming over to fix things, spent time with the kiddos, played video games with them and her, bought food, helped with bills, and taking her to the store. I'm okay with all of that. That's how I was raised to be, is help others. When I needed somewhere to go, stayed with her, that was fine also. The biggest problem I had was, if I came in the door with a smile, I was berated with "who did you go fuck this morning?" or "why did you take so long to get here?" Just in general being told that I'm trying to fuck everything, and have been told at one time I had to look at the floor at the grocery store. She even went as far to tell random women that I wanted their number, and I should go fuck them. I think I'm good now, as the last straw was I was accused of sleeping with her 18-year-old daughter and her 18-year-old friend that stayed the night. The next day I packed my stuff and just said I can't do this anymore, and left. Guys are intimidated by my bye. Talking about their exes. I dated a girl for a few months, and once after sex she said one time I brought this guy home, and while we were fucking he slapped me out of nowhere. It was so weird. So I had a tumult of emotions ranging from post-coitus glow, anger that anyone would slap her, and thinking about someone else in bed with her. I never thought I was her first, but still laid there in silence trying to figure out how to respond, and she said, "Oh, you don't like hearing about me with other guys." Yes, Katie, that would be accurate. When someone doesn't have the desire to understand the perspectives of others, and being quick to anger before communication. Long/fake acrylic nails. Drawn on eyebrows. Both gross me out. Playing hard to get. Mature men who are serious about life will not be turned on by that. They'll shrug and go back to their life. Ain't nobody got time for that. Astrology. A passing interest is fine, but I don't want to hear about how your horoscope told you breathing is a good idea this month. Being entitled to or expecting nice gestures, chivalry is not dead. I will always open the door for a woman and all that cheesy shit, but when a girl stands there expecting me to open the door, that turns me off. Cheating, talking too much, needing to always have word sounds in the air, eyeing, pretending, dishonesty. And dudes. Watching the tiki bari spent years of my life on burn down. Check your grease traps, people. Stupidity. Rudeness. Entitlement. Materialism. Lack of humor. Codependence. Needs help to do anything. Manipulation / playing games / hard to get. Discrimination. Narcissism.